Hi everyone, I'm Prem from Dented Code. In previous video, we installed MySQL database in Windows 10. And in this video, we are going to install MongoDB. And we will use MongoDB Compass as a user interface to access the database. And also we will use command line interface to access database. And I'll show you quickly how we can query database using CLI. Head over to Mongo official website. And okay, just go to docs and server. Click installation, and there is a installation process here. Some of them are a little bit confused, but don't worry, let's do it together. Install, we're going to install community version of MongoDB. So click on that, install on Windows. Okay, so we need the Mongo installation file. Okay, so let's get the Mongo installation file for Windows. It's somewhere down here. Okay, procedure. Okay, the one, download the installer. Okay, open a new window. We need on premises, so which is basically like selected by default, and 4.2.8 is the latest version as per the recording day, and it is detecting my platform Windows. So NMSI is the installation file for Windows. Just click on download. Okay, the file is downloading here. It's saying a minute. I'll pause the video and I'll get back to you once the download is completed. Okay guys, the download process is completed. You can just click here or just go in folder. Go to your download folder and just double click on the installation file. It will open up the installation widget. So let's do next. And click I accept the terms in the license agreement. Next. So just to complete, so you don't want to get confused now. Leave all the default value as it is. Do next. Next. And install. So it is started installing. So if your user account control is set as a recommended by window, it will keep popping up this one. So say yes for it. Okay guys, the Compass is the MongoDB Compass is MongoDB is a database server, so you need to connect to the server to get your data or store the data. So Compass is created by MongoDB same team to access your data with the visual UI. So this one is just giving you beginner guide how to use it. You can just have a look, but don't worry guys, we will go in the future video in detail about all of this. So let's close it, and okay, yeah, start using Compass. Let's connect our MongoDB Compass to our MongoDB database. So let's you can use the URL as well. We go that in detail later in the future. Not in this video, but in the future video. But let's go fill in the field individually. And localhost is the computer host. This is the default port for the MongoDB, and authentication none. Connected. Now, see, you are connected to your database now. So by default, it comes with three databases. Okay. let's quickly see how to create a database. So if you want to create the database, create database, and I just write down my underscore first one, okay, my first MongoDB, and the collection name means collection is like a table. If you are familiar with the SQL database, so the database is database and the collection is same as the table. So let's say I want to put the user table, for example, user, create the table database. See, your database has been created. So the create collection means if you want to create another table, you create here. We don't need to now because we already created user before. So click user, that's a table, and let's insert data. So basically in Mongo, in MongoDB, we call documents because they are in the JavaScript documents, object style data. So insert document and go to the list view, and let's add the row key pair. So basically the way Mongo save data is the key and value pair. So we create key and give the data type. So okay, this one, let's say username and type string. Let's create email, let's give test email at email.com. that's a string too. Okay, so sorry, here supposed to be the key at the front and value at the back. So I'll put key here and value username, maybe dented code. Okay, right, let's insert the data. See, this is the data inserted. So this is how you insert the data. So you want to become a pro MongoDB developer, right? So that means we need to know how to use terminal to access all this data. Okay, let's minimize this. So now let's do one thing before we able to run any Mongo. To run the command line, to use Mongo Service Console, we need to add the Mongo. In order for us to use the command line to access the Mongo database, we need to add Mongo executable files in path variable. To do that, let's find where the Mongo is installed. Okay, let's find where is the Mongo installed. So it's C drive, program files, MongoDB server, the version of the server you installed, and then bin. These are all, like most of them are executable files. So we need to provide this path to our environment variable. Just copy this path and go to Windows Start and just type variable. Edit the system environment variable. In control panel, just click it and open the pop-up window here. Just go to environment variables. And we are not going in the user level, so we're going on system level. So go to the path. There's the path. Edit it. Make sure you do not edit or modify any of this one, otherwise you'll run into trouble using your computer. So just click on new and paste the copied path and hit okay, and yeah, just minimize that one. So the MongoDB binary file is added to our system path, the next thing we need to do is create the folder where you want Mongo to store the data. So that normally you store the data inside the C drive. Inside the C drive, create new folder. Create new folder called data, and inside the data, we create another folder called DB. So when you run the Mongo database server, the database server will be looking for this folder. So every data you are using, storing, or doing all the query, so every data you are storing in MongoDB will be stored here. So this is the file you must create in order to use Mongo. Otherwise it will not work. Okay, let's create that one. And see, there is nothing now. Let's open our command prompt. Open window, hit CMD, hit enter. It will open command prompt. And let's run Mongo daemon. MongoD. MongoD, what it does is that it will tell our computer to run all the binary file we have provided in the path variable and get ready to serve to the client. If you see this one here, okay, quick. Okay, see the DB version here is DB version is 4.2.8. That's what we installed. So that is activated as, and now the server is running. So this is the IP address where by default the server is. This is the server, guys. Okay, you cannot run your MongoDB command query here. So we need to open another CMD, another command prompt. Again, hit window, open window, type CMD and hit it. And here, yeah, I'll just run side by side. Here, I'll just put the you just type Mongo now. So hit enter. That means it will try to connect to the server and make available for you to use Mongo query. It's saying connecting to the our MongoDB on our localhost, and that's the default port. Okay, so the database is ready. Before we start hitting anything, I just want to show you. I left this open to see you guys. Remember when we created this file in C drive, there was nothing. Now, can you see if there are like so many files? So this is all coming from Mongo. So Mongo now do whatever it has to do to store your data and optimize for the query. Let's close this one. So we never have to come here. Okay, this is just wanted to show you. Do you remember when we open our Mongo Compass, we have this data and database we created from here. So this is okay to use like this, but if you really want to become pro, you should start getting used to using command lines. Okay, so here, let's say first thing what you want to do is like see what are the database there. So just type so databases, and these are the 3, 1, 2, 3, 4 databases, which you can see from here. 1, 2, 3, 4 databases. And again, if you wanna use, let's see, if you wanna find this information, we need to go into this database. So type use my first MongoDB. It's saying that switch to DB this one. Okay, that means this database is ready to be accessed. So now let's see what are the table there. So if you are in the SQL database, you use so tables, which it works here as well. See, we have only one table, that's why saying one table, but in Mongo terms you use so collection. See, it's showing the table. If you want to do any query over this user to see this data here, so there is one command. So don't worry too much, don't stress too much about the syntax, query, whatever I'm typing here. This is, I'm just showing you that it's working. Okay, so first we need to tell that we are doing query on database and the table, because we are already inside the database. So just say DB will refer to our my first MongoDB, and dot, we need to put the table name, collection name, user, and to sort it we just put find, and we need this function because the find is function provided by the database. So when you hit enter to open this data, so which is exactly the okay, it's showing too long. You can make it look prettier by using prettier. P-R-E-T-T. I think prettier or pretty. Okay, I think P-R-I-T-T-Y. Okay, yeah, pretty. So see ID, username, and password. The ID, username, and password here. So that means our MongoDB database is installed in our Windows and it's working perfectly. Now we can access using MongoDB Compass as a user interface, or if you want to become like a pro, start using console and use all the queries here. Okay, to go out of here, just type exit by and exit again to close that one. Close this one, and this one we close it too. Okay guys, that's all for how to install the MongoDB in Windows 10.
Thanks for watching this video guys. Hopefully you like this video. If you do like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you are interested in web development and programming, subscribe the channel and turn on the notification by clicking the bell icon so that you'll receive notification of my future tutorials. And if you want to install MySQL database, click on this video. And if you want to install Redis database on your Windows, check out this video. See you next time.